Hear me?
Yes, sir. We can hear you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Anything more, sir? Anything more? Comparison in terms of your different types of internal.
Sir, in closed circuit, the fan does not have to continuously accelerate the air, sir.
Yes, sir. Continue.
Sir, in closed circuit, the fan does not have to constantly accelerate the air, sir.
Fan does not
have to continuously accelerate the air.
But in the open circuit, what will happen?
Sir, since it's coming from the source, which is where the air is stationary initially, we have to continuously accelerate it, sir.
But in the case of closed circuit, it's not required. Is it so?
Yes, sir. Not as much. Operation cost is not as much as open circuit.
Okay. Anything more, sir? Some more types.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, sir. Please tell me.
So there are also wind tunnels that can change the density of air. So we can use it to incorporate compressibility effects as well.
Okay. Good. How are you going to change the density of the air?
So we have these annular wind tunnels that can change the that can incorporate the compressibility.
Whether it's a closed circuit or open circuit, sir.
So it's closed.
Okay. Good. So you are going to incorporate compressibility effect, okay? By changing the you are pressurizing the medium, you are going to change the density.
Yes,
okay. Okay. Anything more? I need a participation. By that time, okay. Flooding of answer. I should get a flood. Answer should come like a flood. Some more.
Sir.
Yes, sir. Please tell me, sir.
Sometimes wind tunnels can be used for specifically for visualization of flow. So you can add smoke or whatever it is. So that, but depending on that, it has to be constructed differently.
Smoke flow visualization. Tunnel also we can have a smoke flow visualization.
Sir, in both closed and open circuit, they'll be having something known as closed jet and open jet. Test section. So in this closed jet and open jet test section, there'll be wall present around the test subject or something in open closed jet. Whereas in open jet, the wall will be absent.
Good, very good. I have mentioned about in the last class. Okay, in the open jet, closed jet facility. In the open jet, that is entrainment of atmospheric air. Air into the tunnel, so we are going to use some devices, that is the arrangement that we are going to introduce. Do you know what is the name of that arrangement? I mentioned in the last class for controlling the air entrainment from the tunnel with the atmospheric air. Yes, sir. Did I mention a section called a breather?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Breather.
Yeah. So, okay. Some more. Good. You came up with very good points. Some more. In terms of application point of view, what are the things you are going to study? Aerospace application or other non-aero applications and all. You didn't talk about anything on high-speed tunnels and all. Have you gone through anything on high-speed tunnels?
Sir, shock tunnels.
What about that shock tunnel, sir? Shock tunnel or a shock tube?
It's called shock tube.
What is the purpose of that shock tube, sir? You might have studied in your commercial fluid flow course, shock tubes.
Sir, do they reduce the shock reflection from the walls?
Is it so? Why the shock reflection is occurring, sir? Any idea?
Sir, because of like boundary, shock reflections will be there.
Why there is a like boundary? Even if it is a concentric tube, are you expecting a reflection? Just I am having a pressure cylinder, okay? I am going to have a connecting a convergent divergent nozzle. I am going to accelerate the flow to a supersonic, whatever the stored flow. I am going to have a constant cylinder over there. Are you going to have a multiple reflection?
Sir, if there are any disturbances, then...
I could not get you. What is the difference, disturbances?
In the direction of flow, if there are any projected surfaces or something, it is possible.
So there is, assume that there is no disturbances.
Sir, if the incident angle is less than theta max, then definitely shock will be forming, sir.
Where is the incidence angle? I'm going to talk about the CD nozzle, and that's going to be connected to a straightly to that, okay? Exit of the your nozzle is going to be a straight pipe.
Okay.
That pipe diameter is going to be equal to the exit diameter of your CD nozzle.
Okay, sir.
Are you thinking that we are going to get a multiple reflection of shocks? What is the kind of shock you are going to get over there? Have you looked at that convergent divergent diffuser, how shock swallowing is taking place? I hinted in the last your aerospace propulsion course. A normal shock is going to form at the initially at the your converging passage, okay? So overspeeding, through the overspeeding procedure, you are going to suck the shock, initially place it at the throat, then they'll make it at like a steady flow. It'll be they'll putting the shock in the diverging passage. So what we call it as shock swallowing. Yes, right now, what is the question right now we are at? We are in the which question, sir? Excuse me. Where are we right now? Yeah.
Sir, how you asked a speed wind tunnel.
Have you heard about, okay, your, okay, shock tube is basically what will happen? You are going to have a, you are going to establish a, yeah, through a constant area pipe, okay, you are going to establish a pressure difference. One is at high pressure, one end is going to be at the high pressure, another is going to be low pressure. So that's going to be separated by a means of a diaphragm. So the moment if you burst the diaphragm, what will happen? Because of the difference in pressure, automatically flow acceleration from high pressure to low pressure, it's going to travel. Depending on the pressure limit, the flow velocities can be fixed. So because of the high velocity, there will be a normal shock formation within the tube. So the shock is going to move within the tube and it's going to hit on the plate and it can come back. It's used to come back. Normally we will talk about that your reflected shocks. Here, if you look at the Mach number 10, 15 and all, you can achieve. But if you want to study some of the your emission characteristics of fuel, why fuel dissociation is taking place, instead of a carbon dioxide H2O formation, why there is a free radical formation. Those material characterization studies and all, you can do it with your shock tube. You got it?
Yes.
Okay. Another type of your supersonic tunnel is your blowdown tunnel and indraft tunnel. Okay. And your hypersonic tunnels also there. We'll go in detail into that while going for, okay, in the classes, coming classes, we'll look at that. We will see more into that. Okay. So another thing that I have told you in the last class, okay, your
some basics on fluid mechanics you told us to refer.
Yeah. Probably share the screen. Oh, it's here. Okay. Now, I have told you to look at the sum 6. How did you see that one? Have you looked at the your hydrostatic equations?
Yes, sir.
Have you looked at the hydrostatic equations? What is it? It's talking about that hydrostatic equations.
So variation of pressure with depth.
Variation of pressure with the depth. Where are you going to apply your hydrostatic equations? Sir, I need a participation learning from whole class. I don't want the answer from a single person. So it's going to be dP by dZ minus, yes, it's going to be rho g. That's rho what. So using these, okay, for example, okay, your force on a submerged bodies. Okay, on floating bodies. And also we looked at that, okay, other thing that we looked at here, okay, your YouTube manometers. Even your standard atmospheric model. So keep in mind that, okay, you look at all those things. Already I told you, mainly I am not going to worry about your flow of submerged bodies and floating bodies, but for your course, okay, I'll be looking into that, your standard atmosphere, okay, and also your YouTube manometer. Based from these one, I am going to ask a question in your examination. You keep in mind that. So if you are not going to read about that, then you are not going to this one ignore. You are going to lose a mark. Okay. So your ISA, mainly you look at that interest standard atmosphere, and what is that your troposphere, tropospause, and stratosphere? How your lapse rate is going to vary? How the rate of variation between these two altitude? Percentage of variation between your sea level to stratosphere or sea level to troposphere, sea level to troposphere, okay? Depending on if they are going to give a height, okay, you can do that. Or otherwise, okay, if you really want to know the numbers, okay, you can just simply in the isentropic calculators and all available will be there. Standard atmosphere data calculator and all available, standard Java applets are available in the some of the websites. You can use that, but you have to know really how you are going to get the data. You can avoid calculator and all, separate story, but you have to know how you got the data. Okay. Next thing is, I told you about the properties, some of the properties I forgot to say that in the last class. Okay. You need to know your viscosity, your dynamic viscosity, and your kinematic viscosity. Relation between dynamic and kinematic viscosity, and also you have to know about that, okay, your Newton's law of viscosity. And also, don't forget to look at, based on Newton's law of viscosity, you look at the classification of your fluids, your Newtonian fluids. If a fluid is going to obey your Newton's law of viscosity, we are going to see that a fluid as a Newtonian fluid. If it is not obey the, your, not obeys the, your Newton's law of viscosity, okay? So what we call it as, it's a non-Newtonian fluid. So if you look at that, you can see that, okay,
sir, stress versus rate of strain graph is not linear in non-Newtonian.
Yeah. So one case, okay, your dow is equal to mu into dou u by dou y. Okay, dou u by dou y. This is going to be your velocity gradient. And this is going to be your shear stress. And this is going to be mu is going to be your coefficient of viscosity, what we call it as a dynamic viscosity. Look at the unit for both of the things, okay? Wherever sometimes if you go for an interview, what is the difference between your dynamic viscosity and kinematic viscosity? What is the necessity of deriving that? What is the formula for that and all? Just look at that, okay? One is going to be talking about the inertia term. Your kinematic viscosity is going to talk about that inertia of the your this one. Read more on that, okay? And you can go ahead with that. For example, okay, your nu is going to be mu by rho.
Rho.
Mu by your rho. So normally in the Navier-Stokes equations and all, we'll be having a mu by rho term will be there after converting that. So for a single entity, we are going for this one as your kinematic viscosity, this one, nu. So basically, it's your kinematic viscosity is going to talk about the inertia of the inertia terms. It's going to talk about the your inertia terms. So here, you have to know, okay, your difference between solid and fluid, solid versus fluid. Your solid versus your fluid. You have to talk about that. Okay. So that you keep in mind that, okay, solid versus your fluid. So what is the prime definition for solid and fluid? So I told you in last class, can you tell any one of you what is the difference between solid and fluid? What is the difference between solid and fluid?
Sir, fluid is a substance which deforms continuously when external shear stress is acting upon it.
Yeah, surely. Very good, very good, very good, very good. So I need a participation from others. So please don't keep quiet. Okay. So we are going to talk about that. Okay, your so here what is going to happen is, okay, we are going to do that a relation between mu and dou u by dou y, sorry, mu by tau, dou u by dou y and your tau, and based on that we are going to classify your Newtonian fluid, non-Newtonian fluid, and all we are going to define ideal fluid, pseudo plastic. Pseudoplastic, okay, yield stress fluid, thixotropic, thixotropic, and your
Brigham plus
Brigham. Okay, so find out what is the peculiarities of ideal fluid, pseudoplastic, yield stress fluid, Brimingham, thixotropic. So those things and all, try to have a small intro about that one. Because the reason why I am talking about that, okay, if you are going to write your ISRO entrance, okay, so there will be a question will be there based on your Newton's law of viscosity, one question. And sometimes they are going to ask, okay, based on your Newton's law of viscosity, if you look at that, okay, you are going to have a disc is going to be there, bottom disc is stationary, top disc is, okay, it's going to revolve with a certain top disc is going to rotate. So if there is a fluid is going to be there, how the your shear stress and all, okay, so those things and all, if you refer, okay, fluid mechanics by F.M. White or K.L. Kumar, you can find a similar kind of problems. So try to work it out on that, okay. So using these, your dou is equal to mu into dou u by dou y, using this formula itself, you can solve these problems, okay. Just look at that, some of the problems, it's going to be useful for your competitive exam preparations, okay. Let I am going to jump into the next part of it, okay. So okay, we have seen that your viscosity. Next thing is, you have to know about that your thermal conductivity, because we are going to use these terms at all here. Your K, that is what we call it as your Fourier law of heat conduction. Okay, and next is your thermal diffusion. What we define is, okay, thermal diffusivity. sometimes they will be taking it as alpha also. Okay, we will check it out. Okay, and we are going to use those things. And other part of is your surface tension. That's all. Your these things you have to know about that. Okay. These are the terms and what is the physical definition for that, what is the use of that, those things you look at that. Already you have studied all those things. You are going to use your surface tension, your these things and all, okay, in your non-dimensional number. For example, Reynolds number, we are going to use one extensively. Reynolds number, your Prandtl number, your Mach number, your Weber number, Mach number, Prandtl number, Froude's number. Okay, so these non-dimensional numbers and all, we are going to use this term. Okay, rho VL by mu. Okay, mu rho by your alpha. Okay. So those things we are going to use these non-dimensional numbers, okay? What we call it as this is a non-dimensional number. We are going to use so extensively these numbers. So we need to know all those parameters here, okay? So just look at that, because this is a prerequisite for this experimental dynamics course. Keep in mind that. So if I'm going to take all those six, I have to take aerodynamics 1 and 2 and your compressive flow back. You can come back to me and you can tell me that. What is the difficulties with that? And next part, okay, in the last class, okay, I told you about your continuity equation, momentum equation, energy equation, those things and all. Okay. And another important thing that you have to know is compressible form of your Bernardi's equation, compressible and incompressible form of your Bernardi's equation. Okay, and same way I mentioned that, okay, in the previous class, your what is that? Your in deriving that your compressible form, incompressible form, what is the assumptions in what? So please keep in mind that, please go and read it. If you have any difficulties, okay, you have a WhatsApp group. So just you put a message to me, okay, still you couldn't understand. One thing is I'll generate I'll take it up in the class, or otherwise I'll take it up some reference from the internet and I'll put it for you. Or otherwise I scribble, I'll take a photo, I'll put it for you. You are going to learn more. These your Bernardi's equations and all, you are going to apply your, okay, your what is that? Where are you going to apply your pita tube measurements and all? So already I talked about your stagnation temperature, stagnation pressure, stagnation temperature. What is the definition of stagnation pressure? What is the temperature of definition for stagnation temperature, stagnation pressure? How are you going to measure your this one, your pita static tube, if you have it? Okay. So this point, what we call it as a stagnation point, and whatever the hole that you are going to develop here, so that's going to measure your static point, static pressure. Or same way, you need to know about thermocouple. We will come back to that. Okay, what do you mean by thermocouple? What is the principle and all? We will come back to that. Okay, your Seebeck effect and all other things. Okay. So here, just look at your Bernardi's equation. Okay, anyway, I'll come back to the compressible form of Bernardi's equation from that. Okay, we are going to do that. Okay, if you are going to treat a flow, compressible flow as an incompressible flow, what is the possible losses with respect to Mach number? What is the percentage increase in error percentage? Those things we can look at that. Okay, so Okay, we'll go into the next part of it. So in the last class, I mentioned about your potential flow. Okay. So here I talked about that your gradient of a pi. That is what we called in this pi as a your velocity potential. Velocity potential. So now, okay, here let us come to this little later. Okay, I am going to have a divergence of a velocity vector. Your velocity vector, I can write it as okay, I cap u plus j cap v plus k cap w. Okay, u is a x component of velocity. V is the your y component of velocity. W is the your z component of velocity. Now, okay, in the case of your divergence of a velocity vector, your del dot v, okay, what we call this del as a del operator. So that we can write it as your del is equal to nothing but I into rho by rho x I cap plus j cap rho by rho y plus w cap into rho by rho z. So you know that a dot product of that, okay, I can write your del dot v as a nothing but your rho v rho u by rho x plus rho v by rho y plus rho w by rho z. So the moment if you look at that your del dot v, the your divergence of velocity vector, okay, it's going to talk about that a mass flux through the from the or mass flux through the mass flux from the your control surface. For example, if I am going to take a control volume like that, okay, I am going to have a small control surface. Through this control surface, how much amount of mass flow is going out? Mass pluses are penetrating into that. Okay, so the physical significance of your del dot v, the divergence of the velocity vector, is going to talk about that. How much amount of mass that is? It's going to talk about that. Your del dot u plus del u by del x plus del v by del y plus del w by del z. Okay. So moment your continuity is going to be talking about that, your conservation of mass, your del dot v is going to be zero. When the conservation of mass, okay, it's going to be talk about that. Okay. It's going to be del dot v is going to be zero. So from that only rho u by rho x, okay, plus rho v by rho y plus rho w by rho z. So when there is a flow is possible, you have to prove that your del dot v is going to be zero. It has to satisfy the continuity equation. Okay. And other thing is that you have to know about is, okay, your del cross v is zero. That is your curl of velocity vector. Your curl of velocity vector. Curl of velocity vector. So here what we can write is, okay, your I cap, j cap, and your k cap. Okay, rho by rho x, rho by rho y, rho by rho z. Your u, v, and w. So you know that determinant, finding the value of determinant. From that you can say that you can find out your curl of your velocity vector, something in the I, okay, plus j, this is going to be w. So you are going to get that one. So your dot product is going to be results in a, we know that, okay, it's going to be a scalar. Your cross product is going to be results in a vector, that also we know that. Okay, so now what will happen? here your del cross v del dot v. So now if you look at that, okay, your curl of velocity vector, if you are going to expand it, and if you are going to look at that, it's going to be equivalent to 2 times your w, that is your angular velocity omega. If you are going to find out the relation for an angular velocity, it's going to be 2 times omega is going to be 0. So now what will happen if the angular velocity associated with the flow, it's going to be 0, your del cross v is going to be 0. Okay, so if the angular velocity is 0, your del cross v is 0, automatically what will happen, your flow is going to be irrotational, because there is no flow is irrotational.
So this del cross v, we call that as vorticity.
Yeah, vorticity. Or we are going to talk about that. Vorticity means what is that? It's going to be circulation.
Yes, sir.
Associated with that. Okay, it's going to be somehow it's associated with the vortex within the present. Angular velocity means what? Okay. So now, if I am going to say that flow as a del cross v is equal to 0, then if I am going to say that, okay, then I can write v is equal to del pi. I can write that, okay, if del cross v is 0, I can write v is equal to del pi. And then, okay, what will happen? Your del dot v, okay, is equal to 0. Already flow is possible, then only del cross v. Your del dot del pi equal to 0. So what will happen? Your del cross pi is equal to 0. What we call this equation as a Laplace equation. So here the pi is going to be your velocity potential. Your velocity potential. So you have to know what you mean by irrotational flow, okay, if they are going to give those things, okay. The next thing is, already in your fluid mechanics as well as your aerodynamics, you might have studied about, okay, your streak line, path line, and your timeline. So what you can do is, in the gate examination, twice they asked about what they had given a flow situation, they asked whether it's a streak line, streamline, or a timeline, or a path line. So refer your fundamentals of aerodynamics by Anderson. Okay, you try to understand along with the example. Okay, come up with a definition. Still, if you have any difficulties, you can come back to me, because already you studied about that. I don't have time to discuss on that. Still, if you have any issues, you can come back to me. I can help you, but you have to read about that right now. So if they are going to give a velocity field, okay, you will be in a position to find out whether the flow is possible. Flow is possible. UVW, the velocity, this one. And also whether the flow is, then the flow is rotational or irrotational. So if you look at that, your V, I can write it as a gradient of your pi. So using this, I can write it as U as a dou pi by dou x, and your v is a dou pi by dou y, and your w is a dou pi by dou z. Same way you can write it as a your stream flux and psi is equal to so there also u is equal to minus dou psi by dou y. V is equal to minus dou psi by dou x. Okay, you can write like that. And if they are going to give a equation for that, okay, you can find out your stream function for that. Even you can write your equation of streamline as dx by u, dy by v, dw by z. If you know the your equation, your velocity field, you can find out the equation of the streamline. This is going to be your equation of the statement. Okay, so just look at these things, okay, your potential functions and other things, okay, even strain, if you want to read more on that, okay, you can read about that, your strain rate also, okay, we will see more on that, okay, in the your coming classes and all, we'll be looking at that more on that. So if I'm discussing some of the basics, please you go through that and you can come back to me. We'll see more in detail. Any other questions, sir?
No, sir.
Okay. 1 minute.